Hey folks, this is Best in Slot with yet another brand new dinosaur game trailer to showcase to you today. This time we're going to take a look at Instinction. This is a action adventure horror shooty sort of game inspired by Dino Crisis first person and looks really interesting. There's a really cool trailer. I'm going to play that for you right now and then we'll discuss it and talk a little bit more about the game. Enjoy.
I wish I hadn't come here for this. I found them. After all this death, if you have a chance to do it all again, what would you have done?
So, pretty cool trailer. I really like this. It's got some great looking dinosaurs. It's got this real... The thing I most liked about it, other than the pterosaur at the end, which we'll talk about in a little bit, it's got this real sense of dread to it almost. You know, this ominous sort of weight hanging over the entire thing that I really, really like. And that might be a weird thing to go for, but particularly in those last few scenes, it had this kind of inevitable... soaring dread accompanying it, which, you know, is cool. Dread is cool. Now, I do want to address something very quickly. As I say, I haven't talked about this game on the channel before, but I did talk about it on Twitter in the past. This is the second trailer they've released. There was a little bit of controversy, something about their dinosaurs being store assets. I think that might still be the case based on an email I got from the devs. They've said that any dinosaurs that are store assets are going to be replaced by the time the game comes out, which is September next year. They are going to be replaced with unique models made by the creators of those assets in the first place. And I'm just going to let the whole thing play through. So start off with our little dude over here. See a little foot in the background. We'll talk about that in just a moment. Some bats, which is cool. So already we're establishing we've got a mix of natural modern animals here, or at least moderately modern, and also prehistoric species. The interesting thing about the landscape, especially this gorgeous shot right here, is this is inspired by Dino Crisis, but Dino Crisis was a very metallic, very laboratory-based game, whereas this is much more naturalistic. We've got that, we've got the ruins here, all overgrown and coated in something. I believe the idea of the game is humans and dinosaurs have been living together in this area. I think it might be like a lost world kind of thing. They've been living together here for generations, for centuries, millennia potentially. So we've got these old ruins all overgrown. We're going to ignore the voiceover ads, nothing. That right there, so I'm just going to nip back very quickly. That is, I believe, the Suchomimus. I will catch the Suchomimus. There we go. I believe that's the Suchomimus. We will get a better look at that in a screenshot in particular just after we've done looking at the trailer. But pretty cool to see a Suchomimus make it into a game like this. You know, it's always nice when we get some different dinosaur species, as far as I'm concerned. Anything that's not a T-Rex is very exciting. And you can see here more of that stuff, more of that tribal stuff. The skulls on the wall with the lanterns in there. This beautifully, intricately designed doorway. Ancient civilizations that have coexisted with dinosaurs for a long time. More Suchomimus. Shooting it seems like a terrible idea. Sorry. So exploring some old ancient ruins. You can see here, actually, just to further this point, there's some cave drawings here at the back. We've got these sort of tribal gatherers over here, these huntspeople. hunts people, huntsmen, hunts women, etc. And then we've got some sauropods on the right-hand side. You know, that would make sense. If you can take down a sauropod, you're going to eat well for quite a long time. And something dead over here, which is lovely as well. Beautiful looking game. This is all, I suspect, slightly bullshotting. You know, it's not necessarily live in-game stuff like this. There is going to be underwater gameplay, which is really exciting. We've got this aquatic creature. If I remember correctly, I believe it's meant to be a chronosaurus. But very, very cool that we're going to get aquatic and aviary species. It's just like evolution too. I have to talk about them in those terms now. But hopefully, you know, imagine swimming around that corner and this chronosaurus is sort of gliding underwater, to, otherwise known as swimming slowly towards you. More opening. Spooky stuff. And again, you feel that. We've got a Smilodon again, so really big variety of prehistoric creatures. We've got a Carnotaurus who looks very disappointed in us, it must be said, but nice and up close here. There's tension here. The raptors, they are Jurassic Parkified raptors, it must be said. I believe this is meant to be Deinonychus. I'm not 100% sure on that. Interestingly enough, the skin has a little bit of Walking with Dinosaurs Utah raptor to me. Now, we don't really know the colours or anything, but just in the striping and the formation, it looks a little Walking with Dinosaurs Utah raptor. You know, I don't think every dinosaur game has to have feathered I'm like a big advocate for feathered dinosaurs, but I think it's okay to have feathered games and Jurassic Parkified games. You know, I think there's a world where we can have both very happily. Some people will be turned off by either or, so choosing between two evils. Oh, they've seen us, it's spooky, and then she just shoots it in the face, basically. This is a game with guns. It's not like that Lost Worlds game we took a look at. This game you will be using actual weaponry to kill things, which again will appeal to some people and won't appeal to others. That's very cool. I love that. Just creeping through a dark forest, flashlight scanning the area. Beautiful light effects here. This is without ray tracing enabled, I believe. The game is currently on Unreal Engine 4. It's going to move to Unreal Engine 5 in terms of by the time it releases. Ugh. Just look at that environment. Isn't that gorgeous? I just want to explore ancient ruins and get killed by dinosaurs. I'm not asking for much. And that's really the one I wanted to look at. That is an Adstarchid. I believe that's a Quetzalcoatlus. It's such a rare thing to see in a video game. It's just really, really cool. Especially when you play as a human. You know, there might be a couple of park builders out there and stuff like that that have Adstarchids, but seeing one as a human up close, these gigantic, mainly terrestrial, vicious pterosaurs, is going to be a really cool experience, and I really hope they do lots and lots of justice to it, because look at that. Isn't that an awesome scene right there? It looks like it's this ancient guardian of the ruins standing atop this flame-wreathed monument. It's very, very dramatic. And she doesn't care. She's like, oh yeah, lava. Never mind the Quetzalcoatlus nearby. So that is Instinction. You can go check out more at hashbane.com. We're going to do just that right now, though, because there's a couple more screenshots. And we also have a species list, which is pretty cool as well. So if you go to hashbane.com, this is what you'll end up with. This is the Instinction website. This is from the last trailer, I believe. So let's just see what they describe the game as. Experience a cinematic, story-based action adventure with combat, exploration, and puzzles, where the environments can be as treacherous and beautiful as the creatures you encounter. Environmental puzzles will have you completing quests and searching for ancient artifacts left by an unknown civilization long since gone. Or so you thought. While navigating stunning locations with ever-changing weather conditions and embark on an unforgettable journey. A little bit of typo there. But yes, I mean, sounds good, right? On the face of it, good stuff. And we also have a little bit more information over here. I'm going to try to summarize these rather quickly, but the extinct creature list includes Acro, there's the whole list right there. I'm not going to read out the entire list, but there is your list right there. And I do see Homo floresiensis, so it does seem that humans will play some part in the game. As long as it's mainly dinosaur focused, that would make me happier. There's some cool things to point out in here though. Dinotherium's in there, Sarcosuchus is in there, some really exciting species. I do have one concern. I think it's important that I at least pretend to be balanced when I do these videos, because I get a little bit caught up in the hype. I am very guilty of that, and I know that. I acknowledge that flaw. You can suggest dinosaurs on social media, and the most popular ones will be included in the game. And that sounds like a positive, but to me that's actually quite a big negative. I think a game should be an artist's vision, especially on a single player game like this. And the dinosaurs should be picked because they best represent the right threat at the right time, or the right area, or the right theme they're going for at that moment, the right atmosphere, blah, 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 blah. And I just don't like leaving things up to social media when it comes to single-player game design. So, a little bit iffy on that, but it is, it's a nitpick, to say the least. And, you know, it's just my personal preference. Multiple biomes from forest research facilities, sea notes and lakes, treacherous ones with gorgeous views, deep cavernous waters to explore. You can hold your breath or use a ventilator. Never relax. Won't be exploring for long before you run into something terrifying. It reminds me a little bit of Tomb Raider, particularly Tomb Raider 2 with the Barracuda level. Was it Tomb Raider 2? I think so. But just imagine, like, you're walking along, you're exploring all these ruins, you find a lake, you dive down, you're swimming around first person, it's dark with the sun rays beaming in a little bit, and the Chronosaurus comes around the corner, or Sarcosuchus, or, you know, we've got something here, yeah, Coelacanth/Morsonia, just these aquatic creatures. We don't see a lot of that, especially in first person, so it'll be really exciting for me. We've got weapons with limited ammo, but multiple attachments and variety, as you can see over here on the left. Combat and exploration. Play smart. This is actually interesting. We'll read this one. You'll be attacked. You'll most likely be killed. Wild beasts are not meant to be your friends. Ironically, some will be. For the most part, you'll need to survive through combat and using your brain. Not all beasts are foes. Some may appear to be nice. Play smart. Complete your objectives. Perhaps consider a side mission. You're in control. Let's hope. So that's interesting, the idea. Not all beasts are going to be enemies. Does that imply we can lead? Are we going to... I assume it's not. Here's our pet Triceratops, or let's mount this Deinonychus or something. That would be bad for the Deinonychus, but let's ride this Chronosaurus into battle. More like, you know, maybe we can lead one dinosaur to another and they can, you know, distract each other and we can sneak past, that sort of thing. And then some customization about things like customizable HUDs, etc. And I've got a couple screenshots down here at the bottom. You can see our Morsonia here, I believe, behind the trailer. Pretty cool. And we've got a little bit more in the gallery. I think this is the Coelophysis, I guess. No idea. Got some blood, which is nice. Our trike there, lovely stuff. Est. No coin this time, interestingly. And this right here, this is Dino Crisis. It's more modern, it's flashier, but it's Dino Crisis. You know, that kind of lab sort of setting. But particularly these red lasers on the right-hand side. If you haven't played Dino Crisis, these were a big thing. I think the next screenshot shows them as well, yeah. There's a much better look at the Suchomimus. Really love the skin patterning there. Someone might well pop up and say this is a store asset. I don't know these things, I've got to be honest. I'm very open to learning about those things. Like, fill me with knowledge, YouTube. But it's a good looking Suco either way. It took me ages to spot the lass on the right hand side, however. She's perched like a monkey, like she's about to jump on the bloody thing. I think she's, you know, sneaking, waiting for it to walk past. But it looks like she's about to bloody dive bomb it. So. And yeah, you can see, you know, we've got some proper heavy weaponry as well. Another look at the... Is it the same Quetzalcoatlus? It looks a little bit different in its styling. I love the crest, though. It looks like a wreath of flame has exploded backwards from the beak. It's got really interesting patterning as well. Civilization has been coexisting with these dinosaurs. They've got cave paintings, we've been told. They've got markings and stuff. It seems that maybe they hunt them for food, but they also revere them at the same time. Ah, that's just going to be... That's maybe my favourite shot. That's all I want. I want to stalk through a dark, creepy, misty jungle with a flashlight and get attacked and killed by dinosaurs. That's really all I want. Here's our, I assume, Spinosaurus, given the big old sail. Doesn't have the proper paddle tail. It's got like a little bit of that going there. But again, I'm not too freaking out about dinosaur assets. Look at that. What a beauty. Anyways, that is Instinction coming. Right, this is important because every time I talk about a dinosaur game, people get really annoyed because most of them just come to PC. But this one, look, PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Xbox Series X, Stadia, which seems like a weird one to me. not sure on that one, but Nintendo Switch as well. At the end of the day, most dinosaur games don't make it. We know that for a fact. Most dinosaur games are DOA. D-O-B-A. Dead... Wait, no. Dead... D-B-O-A, dead, D-B-A, dead before arrival. Bloody no, that's hard work. But the more there are, the more people there are trying, the more chance we have of actually getting one over the line for once, you know? It's a slightly pessimistic view, but I'm hopeful. I really am. Like I said, last time there's a bit of controversy, but it is what it is. I just see a cool trailer and I'm excited and... It's a about it, really, to be honest with you, folks. But feel free to comment down below. Let me know what you think as well. What are you most excited about? What concerns do you have? Both are entirely valid viewpoints. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. It's okay to be hype. It's okay to not be hype. You decide how you feel. I personally, little bit of hype. It's not out for a year yet, though, so we'll hold on for now until we get some proper gameplay. But, you know, you can say that about anything, really, so... Yeah, I'm gonna go before I babble too much longer. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.